coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
It's Friday, October 3rd. It's the Alex Jones Show. I'm your host again, filling in for Alex today, Paul Joseph Watson with you for the full 3 hours. We've got David Knight back in studio coming up in the last hour. In the second hour, we're going to go to an interview with Syrian girl who's going to talk about ISIS, the airstrikes, questioning, are they actually having an effect on killing ISIS members? It appears that the opposite is the case. ISIS is advancing. We're also going to talk about Gamergate, which is this basically huge open conspiracy within the video games industry, where social engineers and feminists have infiltrated video game making companies and the video game media to implant messages of social engineering. It's kind of a topic that's bubbled under the surface a little bit over the past month, but we're going to get into it with Syrian Girl. We've also got a tribute to Stan Monteith coming up at the bottom of the hour, so be sure to stay tuned for that. The latest news surrounding Ebola, of course, the CDC's response goes from concerning to downright alarming. We've got a top story on Infowars.com right now. Ebola patient's family under armed quarantine. This just came out around about 30 minutes ago out of the Associated Press originally. Basically, the family of the Ebola patient in Dallas tried to escape the apartment in which they're being quarantined, obviously because of their exposure, potential exposure to the Ebola virus. So we've got that story up on Infowars.com. Coming up now after the break, we're going to play this clip from Anderson Cooper. And this is just, again, astounding. He interviews the partner of the Ebola victim who's still obviously holed up there in the apartment in Dallas. And she basically tells him, the CDC gave them no advice, no information whatsoever on how to deal with the vomit, diarrhea, sweat-stained Ebola bed sheets of this Ebola victim who had been staying in that apartment, of course, for days after he had contracted the virus. So we've got that clip coming up. Again, absolute incompetence on behalf of the CDC. It goes from bad to worse. There's a CNN story. Frustrated woman quarantined with sheets, towels soiled by Ebola patient. We've got that clip coming up after the break from CNN. You've got to see this. Also, out of Breitbart today, co-workers of US Ebola patient, he knew he had Ebola, he was desperate to survive. Now, a couple of days ago, I made the comment that this guy could have been an Ebola tourist. He could have been coming to the US specifically to get treatment in the knowledge that he wouldn't get such treatment in Africa, of course, where they're completely overwhelmed with the spread of Ebola. Well over 3,000 people dead now as a result of this outbreak. The hospitals cannot take any more patients. We've seen videos of people dying on the street. So now the boss of this Ebola victim who came into Dallas is basically saying, quote, if he were in Liberia, he was going to surely die, saying he was glad that Duncan was in a country with adequate medical resources. So he's basically making the point that in a, quote, desperate attempt to survive, the Ebola victim, Thomas Eric Duncan, came into Dallas deliberately to get treatment that he knew he wouldn't get back in Liberia. Also, shocking story that I put out last night. Shock image shows unprotected workers cleaning up Ebola vomit in Dallas. Now, this is a shot, an image out of a HD Chopper 8 crew from WFAA. And this shows the workers cleaning up the sidewalk outside the apartment where the Ebola victim stayed, where he vomited on the sidewalk. Now, it's not clear whether they're actually cleaning up the Ebola vomit, but they're in the area, they're cleaning the sidewalk where this patient stumbled and fell before he got into the ambulance and was taken to the Texas Presbyterian Hospital. So obviously no protection whatsoever. And we're going to delve more into that, more into CDC incompetence with this Ebola situation after the break. The news is all circulating around this apartment where the family members are currently quarantined. Syrian Girl coming up second hour. David Knight, third hour. We've also got news on the economy, the 5.9% unemployment rate. What they're not telling you about that. It's the Alex Jones Show live. Stay tuned, Infowars.com. Like Simpsons is being treated at Howard University Hospital in D.C. A hospital spokesperson confirmed late Friday morning the patient had traveled to Nigeria recently. That person has been admitted to the hospital in stable condition and is being isolated and tested. The medical team is working with the CDC to determine whether the patient has Ebola. So another potential case there. We've seen others turn out to be negative. Hopefully that's the case again. But we've also received reports, calls to other shows, and I saw this story out a couple of days ago, again unconfirmed, but that people in Dallas are receiving phone calls from health authorities, whether that be the CDC or emergency managers, who were living in the immediate area surrounding the apartment where the Ebola victim lived, and they're being told to either stay indoors or are being given advice on how to spot potential symptoms of Ebola and how to protect themselves. So again, that's unconfirmed, but later we'll take calls. Hopefully people from Dallas can call in and tell us if they've had any information on that, if they've received any such calls. I know a couple of days ago there were reports of robocalls coming in from the CDC to residents in Dallas warning them about precautions to take regarding Ebola, so we'll continue to track that. Now, this apartment, which the news seems to be centering around today, where the Ebola victim stayed right before he was taken to hospital after obviously having been sent back home from hospital 2 days prior, having been given antibiotics. Article up on Infowars.com right now from Mikhail Phelan here. Sheriff's officers fearful after being ordered into quarantined Ebola apartment. Five employees with the Dallas County Sheriff's Department entered the quarantined apartment of Ebola patient Thomas Eric Duncan Wednesday night after being ordered to bring his four family members a court order barring them from leaving their home. The five, who were ordered to enter the residence by Sheriff Lupe Valdez, were joined by a doctor and the head of the Dallas County Health and Human Services Department. The incident was learned after the sheriff's deputies noticed the squad cars used by the five being taken out of service unexpectedly the following morning. And we can get into this further, actually, in a separate article. Here's the quote, actually. This is from Sheriff's Association President Christopher Dyer, who said the sheriff's members were uneasy at best, having been told to enter this potentially Ebola-infected apartment. My concern is for the deputies and their families, said Dyer, and I want to see Dallas County do everything that they can to alleviate their concerns. My anger is really with the feds, Dyer said. Let's move that family. Let's move everybody out of that building. I don't care if it's overkill. Let's do overkill. I don't think sending a few deputies in there is the right course of action. Then if you look at this tweet from Scott Gordon out of NBC5 here, four sheriff's deputies, health director, doctor, went into Ebola victim's apartment without protection last night, Sheriff's Association says. And then I actually have an image here on the desk of three individuals waiting to enter the potentially Ebola-infected apartment, obviously wearing no protection whatsoever. It's not clear whether these are involved with the law enforcement authorities that entered that apartment. But again, it shows you the complete lack of protection that's being taken, given the knowledge that this Ebola sufferer was in that apartment for a matter of days. We're going to go to this Anderson Cooper clip now, which is an interview with the partner of the Ebola victim. Just listen to what the CDC told her, or what they didn't tell her, about how to deal with the bed sheets, with the towels that this Ebola victim had used before he was taken to hospital. Let's go to the clip.
So that was the first time they mentioned to you Ebola?
Yes.
When you heard that, what did you think?
I was so scared.
When you were caring for him, did you get in contact with any fluids?
Not I know of.
Did the CDC recommend that you clean your apartment?
I told them I just, my daughter brought me some Clorox, and we sprayed the Clorox on the mattresses on my bed, and I tie dirty clothes on in a plastic bag, all sealed up, and that's it. But they said I shouldn't throw anything away until they can get back with me.
So the sheets that Thomas used and the towels that he used, what have you done with those?
They are in a plastic bag.
In your apartment?
Uh-huh.
So you put the, you took them off the bed and put them into a plastic bag?
No, under the towel is in a plastic bag, but the rest of the stuff stayed the same on the bed. The bed sheets, everything is on the bed.
So the sheets that he used, that he slept on, that's still on the bed?
Yeah.
How are you coping with this?
I'm just hanging in there, depending on God to save our lives.
Depending on God to save your lives.
Yeah. At the time come, let us be free, because people are telling lies.
So you feel like people are not informed about how you actually get Ebola. You actually have to come in contact with the body fluids of somebody who is not only infected, but actually sick with Ebola.
Yeah, and we are not sick with Ebola.
Right. Mm-hmm. And so, and at this point, even if you had Ebola,